AI girlfriends, OnlyFans subscriptions, deep fake porn. We are living in a culture where fantasy is replacing reality. And here's the brain truth that nobody's talking about. The more you bond with fake intimacy, the harder it will be to connect with people in the real world. That's why erectile dysfunction and loneliness are skyrocketing. I'm Dr. Trish Leigh. Today, I'm breaking down how AI porn and parasocial intimacy are literally desexualizing your brain. We live in a world where men are paying for AI companions, following OnlyFans models, subscribing to chatbots that promise emotional connection. And the numbers, they are striking. Only about 4.2% of OnlyFans subscribers actually pay. And on average, they only pay $48.52. Yet those rare interactions, they are very powerful. The top spenders on OnlyFans, guess what they're interested in? More than explicit matter, they want emotional connection. They talk about their pets, their work, and their mundane life activities. On the surface, that might look harmless, maybe even empowering, until, of course, you realize your brain can't tell the difference between real intimacy and fantasy. The same bonding chemical, oxytocin, it fires when you're with a real partner or a programmed performance persona. That means if most bonding comes from pixels, real life intimacy can feel flat, boring, maybe even hollow. Men are paying for connection out of their wallets, but what they probably don't realize is that they're actually paying out with their brain too. Every subscription, every chat, every fantasy, it's not just money out of your wallet, it's also dopamine and oxytocin miswiring the reward center and pathways in your brain. You think you're buying intimacy, but you're actually giving away your power. Number one, we have the dopamine hijack. It's the slot machine effect. Every AI notification, text bubble, new image, it triggers a spike of dopamine in your nervous system. But the responses, they're unpredictable. It mirrors the variable reward schedule, just like in slots and gambling apps. And it's actually the most addictive type of reward in neuroscience. Your brain gets locked in a loop, constantly checking for the next reward. Number two, oxytocin misfires. That creates counterfeit bonds. Oxytocin, the bonding hormone, it fires whether you're with a real human partner or an AI illusion. The problem is with AI companions or deep fake porn, that currency of connection is being spent on pixels, not people. The result? Real intimacy begins to feel bland and boring, maybe awkward, or even emotionally empty. The brain bonds with illusions and struggles to reconnect with reality. Number three, the prefrontal cortex weakens. This means loss of control. The prefrontal cortex is the executive control center in your brain. It regulates decision-making. It helps you to hold off on impulses. It also helps you to focus and to set and achieve long-term goals. Chronic stimulation from AI porn overloads this circuit. On brain scans, we see reduced gray matter density. This is the same thing we see in cocaine and gambling addicts. The result? Users describe the feeling of not wanting to click, but not being able to stop. This isn't just personal, it's cultural. We see more men than ever retreating into AI partners. We see deepfakes, images, being used to weaponize against women, creating humiliation. We see an entire generation struggling to form and maintain healthy relationships. If left unchecked, AI porn won't just damage brains. It will destroy society. It's like training an entire culture to bond with ghosts instead of real people. Then wonder, why do those people have ED? Why are they lonely? Why are they anxious? Why are they depressed? Marriage rates collapse. Productivity down the drain. Families, no. But there's hope. There's a path back. Neuroplasticity states your brain can recover. No matter how long you've been stuck, here's the path back. Step number one, remove the overstimulation. You know it. You must stop flooding your brain with artificially high levels of dopamine. So you have to cut the AI porn, the deepfakes, the parasocial relationships with creators. You have to cut the endless cycle of digital novelty. Just like taking your foot off the gas gives the engine the opportunity to cool down, when you remove the overstimulation, you allow your brain to reset. Number two, retrain bonding. At first, real intimacy with a partner might feel flat, or it might feel weird and awkward, but you're not broken. Your brain is in process. It is resensitizing. With consistency, your oxytocin and dopamine will begin to fire up again for real love, and you will begin to feel energized and alive again. Step number three, restore control with neurofeedback. This is where my neurofeedback brain training program comes in. I'm fortunate to be at the forefront of creating protocols that allow us to visualize how AI porn, how deepfakes, how those parasocial relationships have miswired your brain, how they've hijacked the control center and the bonding centers. But more importantly, then we can use that brain tech to rewire your brain away from that distortion and back into your actual life with a real partner. In this way, you can feel and perform better than ever. If you want more information, please go over to drtrishleigh.com and check it out. You can download my free guide, Pleasure Pathway Reset. It'll give you more information. Stay here with me. Click the video that's coming on the screen now, because this video is part of my series on AI porn and how it impacts your brain, how it contributes to erectile dysfunction, and what you can do to get the power back. So leave a comment. Let me know, how has this impacted you? What scares you more? How AI porn looks so real, or what it does to your brain? Right now is time to take the control back. I want you to remember, control your brain or it will control you. I'll see you next time.